right now. Thank you for your anointing, oh God, that destroys every yoke and bondages off our lives, oh God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for opening up the eyes of our understanding that we might behold green and wonderful things out of your word today, God. Anoint me to bring it clearly, oh God, and anoint the hearers to hear it clearly.
Yes.
What the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church. So, Father, we thank you now. Thank you for the angels that encamped all around about us. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. Do you guys believe that there are angels in this place?
Amen.
Yeah. There are angels in here. Because the Bible says that the angels are camped all around about us. So we have angels that are camped all around these walls over here. All in here. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. Let me look at my time. Okay, babies. I want to do a short teaching this morning on the gift of righteousness. The gift of righteousness. 2 Corinthians 5:21. It says, for he hath made him to be sin for us who knew no sin. He didn't know any sin. But he was made sin for us that we might be made the righteousness of God in him, in Christ. God loves us. We as saints of God don't really comprehend the love that God has for us. We don't really comprehend that. 2 Corinthians 5:21 says, for he hath made him to be sin for us. Who did he make to be sin for us?
Jesus.
He made Jesus to be sin for us. Jesus didn't know any sin, right? He didn't know any sin. But he made him to be sin for us so that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. How about that? Righteousness, to be put in right standing with God. If you meditate on that and think about that, to be in right standing with Jehovah God, the creator, the supreme being, the master builder, architect, and designer of everything, to be in right standing with him.
Glory to God.
You got to meditate on that thing so that's going to hit you. That you are in right standing with God. I'm talking about the master builder, the architect and designer of everything, the creator God, the one that stepped out and said, let there be light. And there was light. Do you hear what I'm saying up in here? The one that hung the sun, the moon, the stars.
Come on now.
Flung it out there in space on his word and said, stay right here. Don't move. And it's still standing there that day. We're in right standing with that God,
right,
the supreme being. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Good God from Zion. You got to get this thing. Now, spiritual righteousness is the quality of being right in the eyes of God. All of us want to be right in the eyes of God, right?
Yeah.
The righteousness is the spiritual quality of being right in the eyes of God, including our nature, our attitude, our actions, and our words. Righteousness is therefore based upon God's standard because he is the ultimate lawgiver. Did you hear what I said? Righteousness is based upon God's standard, not man's standard. You know, you're not right in your own. This is my truth. You hear folks say, this is my truth. Righteousness based upon God's standard. Because Isaiah 33 and 22 says that God is the ultimate, what? Lawgiver. Yeah. He is the supreme being. Uh-huh. He's the supreme lawgiver.
Amen.
And judge. Righteousness is a God-centered attribute. No man can attain it through his own efforts. Do you hear what I'm saying? Through his own efforts, apart from God's ordinance. You can't get righteous on your own.
No.
In comparison to God's righteous, our righteous deeds are nothing but filthy rags, according to Isaiah 64 and 6. You see what I'm saying? Isaiah 64 and 6, you need to write those scriptures down so whenever we leave here, you can go back, because I don't have time for us to look but read them now. I'm going to speak this word out to you, and your job is to write them down, and whenever you go back and look at this message again, you'll know what it says. Because
right.
See, I'm going to take it for granted that you're going to go back and listen to it again. Mm-hmm. Because if you want to learn anything, you just can't learn something about hearing it just one time.
That's right.
Do you understand what I'm saying over here?
That's right.
Yeah, see, that's what the devil done tricked us so much, and that's why we're living so beneath our privilege, because we just take something one time, go out the door, and he'll stole that, you don't know nothing.
That's mm-hmm. right.
But see, now we got so much unbelief in us until it's going to take a faith comes out what? Hearing and hearing and hearing. Now we got so much faith, unbelief down in us, we're going to have to hear this over and over. Hear this word on healing over and over and over. Hear this word on finances over and over and over before it's going to manifest in your life. Do you hear what I'm saying up in here? That's a truth that God, the Holy Spirit, has burnt deep down in me. That you're not going to, these blessings are not just going to fall on out the sky on you.
That's right.
Righteousness is a God-centered attribute. No man can attain it through his own efforts. Righteousness is a wonderful gift from God to humanity through who? Christ.
Right.
Act of love. What love? You see that? You know what I'm talking about. Love. Do you, who? Babies, you got to wake up and smell the coffee and know who you are in Christ Jesus. When you receive Jesus Christ, you got to realize who you are in him. See, some of us don't even want to read the word so that we can find out what he has done for us, who God is, what do we have. You know, I know when you receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you get saved. Saved from what? Saved from the wrath to come, because there's a wrath coming on this unbelieving world. Do you hear what I'm saying up here? So now we're saved from that. Once you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are saved from the wrath to come. Because you tell somebody, I'm saved. They said, what you saved from? From. Anybody ever ask you that? What you saved from? You saved from the wrath to come, but it's a wrath coming on this world. So now you ain't have to go through that wrath. The Bible says it's a bad thing to fall into the hands of an angry God. And see, right now, God is not even angry. Why? Because of who?
Jesus.
He done paid that sin debt for the whole world. Now, since the death and resurrection of Christ, the purpose of the law has been fulfilled. The purpose of the law. We studied Romans now.
Uh-huh.
We're in the book of Romans. Do you know what the law came for? The law came to show us that we need a Savior. Uh-huh. The law came to show us that we couldn't keep it in our own selves. Do you hear what I'm saying over here? That's why the law came. Now, those of us that are in the book of Romans, we studying that. So we're going to be on chapter what this week?
Four.
Okay, you need to go back and read 1, 2, 3 again. Since the death and resurrection of Christ, the purpose of the law has been fulfilled. As a result, everyone who believes in him is made right with God. How do you get made right with God? Romans 3:22. You get right with God by doing what? Talk to me. Accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Am I going too fast for you?
No,
you didn't have time to answer.
I just didn't want to say it. Say everything.
Talk to me. Let me know you're out there. Christ is the perfect revelation of God.
Wow.
And our faith in him leads us to the righteous God, to the righteousness of God. Our faith in Jesus Christ leads us to the righteousness of God. That's Romans 1 and 17. Romans 1 and 17. See, God is the one that makes us right in his sight. You can't make your own self right in God's sight. I don't care how many times you come to church, how many times you usher, how long you been on the Usher Bird. How long you been sung in the choir?
Wow.
It doesn't make any difference. That don't get you nowhere.
That's right.
That can't get you saved. You got to receive Jesus Christ.
That's right. Amen.
God's son that he sent down here to pay the sin debt.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, believing in Jesus Christ is the work of faith. Not the work of your flesh. It's the work of faith. Look at Romans, you know, Romans 4, 5, and 6. Write it down. Romans 4, 5, and 6. Righteousness is the God-given quality imputed to man upon believing in Christ. In other words, righteousness is the God-given quality credit to man upon believing in Christ. Did you see what I'm saying? Amen. You didn't know it. You heard it, but you ain't acting on it. It's like you don't know it enough to let me see you holler. Let me see you do something.
No, that's right.
You hear what I'm saying? God. Can you tell that I done got it. Revelation.
Amen.
I'm trying to get y'all. Lord have mercy, I'm trying to get it to you. The relationship between God and man, which was broken because of what? Talk to me. Yeah, because of sin. The relationship between God and man was broken because of sin.
Yes, because
of who brought the first sin into the world? Who?
Adam
and Eve. So the relationship was broken.
Mm-hmm.
Now it is being restored through who? The sacrifice of Jesus, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the what?
Sins of the world.
Good God from Zion. Don't you know one time you couldn't even talk to God?
Amen.
Because you were separated from him.
That's right. Glory
you,
to God.
Hallelujah. You was hoping he heard you. But now, so you got to know he hear you now, because once you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior, you have the relationship has been consummated, come back together again. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Now you can come boldly to the throne of grace to find help in time of need. Glory to God. In him we are forever loved by God unconditionally. In him, in Christ. Just as children are forever loved by their parents, no matter what they do, we're going to love our children, ain't we?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I tell my sons and grands. Always tell me the truth. Because
uh-huh. Yes,
I'm going to love you regardless.
Amen.
Of what you do.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to still love you. Mm-hmm. Just tell me the truth so that I know how to respond whenever I have to go stand in the gap for you.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Yeah, yeah. See what I need? I need a helmet.
That's right.
Just tell me the truth. Don't lie to me now. No. But see, we're going to love our children no matter what. And see, we are accepted and justified not by our own goodness, but by the perfect love of God. See, God loves us unconditionally. Uh-huh. He loves us so much that he'll let us make our own choices.
That's right.
He said, if you make your bed in hell, I'm going to still love you. Uh-huh. Good God, from Zion. He loves you so much that he'll let you choose to go to hell. Because he done gave you he made you a free moral agent to choose. He'll let you keep right on doing anything you feel like you're big enough to do.
That's right.
He ain't gonna come down here and knock this out your hand, take this out your arm, or get you out of that bed.
That's right.
But let me tell you, baby, you got consequences.
Consequences, yeah.
You reap what you sow. This grace and mercy of God does not mean we have a license to sin. Do you hear what I'm saying?
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
It don't mean we got a license to sin now because of that law. Because it's cause and effect. Mm-hmm. Always. Having been so tremendously loved by the Heavenly Father. See, we got to think about that love, how much God loves us. But see, he loves us, but he's a just God.
Yes.
He don't love like we do. We can tell him, I'm going to spank your butt if you don't get right. This, I'm going to spank your butt. You don't never do it. But see, in the kingdom, in God's laws, he don't have to spank your butt because the penalty has already been placed in the commandment.
That's right.
You see. So if you disobey, the consequences of that are going, you're going to reap them.
You're going to get them. That's right.
Cause and effect. And we have to know about cause and effect because so many bad choices we made.
My God.
And we see the effect of it, don't we?
Yes. Amen.
Having been so tremendously loved by the Heavenly Father, we are to express our gratefulness by continually living in his righteousness. Mm-hmm. You know, whenever you mess up, you know how grateful, you be so grateful, you know how much God loves you, and then you mess up, that ought to do something to your heart.
Amen.
It ought to prick your heart. And you say, God, please forgive me. Because he knows we're not perfect. But we're supposed to be striving for what? To be like, yeah, and then look like Jesus. That's our prize and high calling. That's who we're supposed to be patting ourselves after, right? When you were born again, you weren't half reborn. You weren't made half righteous. You were made the righteousness of God in Christ. You were made a joint heir with him.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Hallelujah. We were made a joint heir with Jesus Christ. And everything that Jesus has belongs to us as well. Mm-hmm. Can you see that?
Amen. Yeah.
I mean, just think about it. I'm a joint heir with Jesus. I'm a joint heir with Jesus. See, Jesus went to the cross to give you what he already possessed. He rose again so you could be recreated in his image. You are more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. Do you realize that? We are more than conquerors. We have the victory. But see, we keep looking at what we see with our eyes. And the devil talking to you, you ain't got the victory. You look at your pocketbook, it's talking to you. Uh-huh. You ain't got no money. But see, you going right along what that pocketbook saying to you, what the devil, yeah, you right. I was so broke, I can't even pay attention. See, you are more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. I don't care what the devil, that's not, this thing does seem a what? Temper.
Right.
That means they're subject to change at any time. Mm-hmm. Suddenly. You keep standing on that word, and after about suddenly, a breakthrough done came.
That is
God.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. See, it doesn't matter how badly you may have messed things up yesterday, or how many mistakes you have made, you can begin this day knowing you are righteous. You are in right standing,
yes,
with God.
Yes.
Not because of anything you've done,
uh-huh,
but because you've received by faith in Jesus the very righteousness of God. God made you righteous. Do you hear what I'm saying? That don't mean you're perfect now. But God fixed you so that you can stand before him. He put that righteousness on you in Christ. So whenever he sees you in Christ,
uh-huh,
when he looks at you, he sees you in Christ. Do you hear what I'm saying up here? And see, if you continue to walk around here and speak the word of God out your mouth, and speaking, no matter what it looks like, you got your armor on, the devil don't know who you are. Because you got your helmet of salvation, all that pulled down. You got the breastplate of what?
Righteousness
on you. Feet shod, girded with the truth. And you speaking what God said. You going out there speaking. The devil don't know that's you. He all he hears the word of God. He thinks it's God. But as soon as you open your mouth and say, oh my God, my feet are killing me, and I ain't gonna never get nowhere in God. A post. Ping. Booyah. Mm-hmm. You know that's you. So our words matter. Okay. Just like, let me tell you, now we got benefits. There are benefits that being righteous will bring. Okay? Let's look at this right here. God's word says, in Psalms 92 and 12, the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. Do you hear what I'm saying up here? The righteous. Who's the righteous?
We are.
Who the justified ones?
We are.
Okay. Now he says, we shall flourish like a palm tree. What does that mean? Have you ever thought about studying the palm tree? What is that like? You know, whenever he tells us that the righteous are bold as a lion, you ever thought about he compared us to a lion. The righteous are bold as a lion. Do you know what a lion do? Lion is king of the jungle, ain't he? He walks in the jungle with his head all up looking around. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, you know, hey, the king is here. You ever see how the lion walks around? Because he thinks he's the bad. You see, he got confidence knowing who he is. And he's not even the biggest. He's not even the fastest. He's not even the tallest. He can't even outrun the cheetah. But the cheetah's scared of him. And once he opens his mouth and roar and right back, oh, everybody in town starts to shake. In the jungle town. See, he said the righteous are bold as a lion. And let me tell you, let's get back here to like a palm tree. He said, the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. Girls, I looked up what palm tree means. Palm tree, a palm tree. A palm tree is strong. A palm tree can live up to 100 years. The palm tree is very elastic. It's flexible. The roots of the palm tree go down very deep. And as I did my study, it says that the palm tree comes out of storms even stronger. Good God from Zion. Do you hear what I'm saying over here? A storm makes a palm tree stronger. So whenever you're going through your trials and your tribulations, you ought to come out stronger than you went in that trial. Do you hear what I'm saying up in here? Hallelujah. He said you shall flourish like the palm tree. Flourish means to increase. Mm-hmm. Do better. Your borders enlarged. Flourish. Prosper. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Thank you, Jesus. You got to meditate on this right here. Meditate on. Mm-hmm. And then he says, it's Proverbs 11:21. The seed of the righteous,
all right, man,
shall be delivered. Do you hear what I'm saying? The seed of the righteous. He said, now he's talking about our children. Because we fear him and delight great in his commandments, our generation shall be mighty and great on the earth. The seed of the righteous shall be delivered. Whatever they're going through right now, they shall be delivered. You stand on that word. The seed of the righteous shall be. It is written, devil. The seed of the righteous shall be delivered. That's the word you stand on for your children.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying? You got to get that word in you. I heard it one time. Mm-hmm. And thank you, God. Mm-hmm. See, you got to believe. You got to choose to believe the word of God. See, you got to choose to believe the word of God. Do you choose to believe the word of God? That's what it comes down to. I choose to believe. And then 1 Peter 3:12. He says, the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous, and his ears are open to their prayers. Do you hear what I'm saying? Oh my God. That means that the eyes, God's eyes, are over you, and his ears are open to your cry, open to your prayers. His eyes. The Bible said he's going, his eyes go through and forth throughout the earth looking for somebody that believes in him so that he can show himself strong on their behalf. Mm.
Come on now.
His eyes.
Come on.
Psalms 5:12 says, you, O Lord, will bless the righteous with favor. You will surround him as a shield. You know what a shield is? Mm-hmm. A shield is something you put all the way around you, right? He's going to bless the righteous with favor. So you are always talking about the favor of God is upon me. I mean, when you get up and go out, everyone, the favor of God is on me today. The favor of God. And you have to say that, continue to say that. And then even though sometimes whenever you go out there in the shopping centers and you get a good park, you say, the favor of God. Thank you, Lord, for the favor. Yes. Thank you for the favor, Lord. Favor. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You, O Lord, will bless the righteous with favor. And you think about it. God will give you favor on that job.
Amen.
God will give you favor in your business.
Yes.
You, because you're righteous. How do you get righteous? Because God has made you righteous. Because you have received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
how come he gonna give you favor? Because you're righteous in his sight. You're in right standing with God because you received his son. Not because you're so good. And you crossed every T and dotted every I. But you did the one main thing, that was what? To receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. I can't save myself. God, I need a Savior.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I can't live right. God, I need a Savior.
That's right.
Oh my God. Psalms 34:17. It says, the righteous cry, and the Lord hears them.
Hears.
And delivers them out of all their troubles. You're righteous. God has made you righteous in him. Y'all expect your prayers to be heard and answered. This is the confidence that we have in him. That if we ask anything according to his what? His will and his word, he what? Hears us. Now, if we know that he hears us, then we know that we have a petition that we desire from him. So thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Psalms 37:25, did I say that?
No.
This is what David said. I have been young.
All right.
And now old. Yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Do you hear what I'm saying up in here?
All right now.
Jesus said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you.
That's right.
David said, I've been young, but now I'm old. But there's one thing I done seen. I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Right,
God, oh my God.
Yeah.
Woo! He said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken. And I've never seen the seed, their seed begging bread. So I think about that sometimes when I see some of these guys standing out there in the corner begging. Some of them doing it because they want to. Some of them got Christian prayer. They ain't got no business out there begging.
Amen.
And they doing it. Some of them don't. They don't want to work. Some of them. Because my son, you know, he's in business for himself. He pulled up beside one that had to sign out on his way to work. He said, man, he said, if you want to work, jump in the truck. I'll pay you at the end of the day. No, man, go ahead on. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And there ain't no shame in that game.
Amen.
I'd be ashamed to stand out that side of the road begging for the side. Do you hear me? Oh, no, sir. Yeah, that's not that. You stand out there long enough, everybody come by there and give you a dollar. Bob, if you stand out there long enough, you done had $100 in one day. I know they do, buddy. They can somebody stay out there at 12 o'clock and make $100.
Then they get in their car and ride.
Psalms 37:29. The righteous shall inherit the land.
That's what I'm saying. The righteous is paying.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord, for our land.
Amen. That's it. Right
there. Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Yeah. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell in it forever. Glory to God. See, I'm standing on that for our land, our church building. You hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Hey, I don't care if a few of us, we can get it, we can do it. For with God, all things are possible. If God be for us, who can be against us?
That's right.
And when y'all have to stand on, if you believe in God for your house, you have to stand on that word for your house.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God up in here.
Yeah.
See, don't let the devil rob you of these blessings by telling you you're unworthy of them.
Uh-huh.
Now he'll come to you, tell you.
Yes, he will.
Yes, sir. He'll talk to that head.
Yes, he will. He's a lie, though.
And sometimes he'll be telling you the truth about him. So what you got to say, devil, you right on this right here, but I'm getting my hips straight with on that. Hello, somebody up here. Is anybody in the house of God this morning?
Amen.
So, you know, let's step up to the position of authority that Jesus has given us. Good God, do you know who you are in Christ Jesus? And learn to operate the way he does. Let's learn to operate. You've got to get in this word before you go learn how to operate like God. Before you learn how to operate like Jesus. See, we get a little word and pull it out and read that, and we go on about a bit. You have to meditate, baby. And like I did, you tell me before. Faith comes by repetition. Faith comes by repetition. Meditating on it, repetition. That's how you learn. And then, like I said, we got so much unbelief in us that we got to keep putting this word in us, these scriptures in us, to drive out all that unbelief. Because God says, without faith is what?
Impossible
to please him. Mm-hmm. He that cometh to God must believe that he what? That he is.
And a reward.
And a reward to them that diligently seek him. What did I say diligently means last Sunday? Who remembers? Shanti, you remember what I said diligently?
Like what, everything?
Mm-hmm. Everything you got?
I got.
I mean, what else?
Wholehearted.
What's the number?
Putting forth an effort.
Put forth an effort. How bad do you want it? Mm-hmm. My God, how bad do you want it? How bad do you want to see these promises of God materialize in your life? We're going to have to turn down the plate sometimes. We got to turn off the TV sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah, because see, the devil couldn't keep you from getting saved, but he can keep you a slave. He can keep you a slave, cause you're not gonna get straightened out until you get your mind renewed. Cause you see, when you got saved, you still got that same old mind that you had. Mm-hmm. So that's why he told us to get your mind renewed, so you can think like God. Because you saved, your spirit saved, but your mind still the same.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? And it's going to do what it used to do. It's going to say what it used to say, mm-hmm. And it's going to cuss out who it wants to cuss out.
Well.
Ain't that right, Jay? Glory to God, I tell you. This is good to me. I don't know whether it's good to you or not, but you got to get where I am.
All right.
So I'm telling you to come on up higher, because this is good word. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The just shall live by his what? Faith. Faith. Faith.
Oh, I got faith. Show me your faith then.
Oh, what you done got by faith? You know.
No, that's right.
Show me what you got by faith. By faith, I have received automobiles. I have received my healing in my body by faith. Automobile. Did nobody give me no money? Would nobody let me have no money? I didn't have enough money to buy a car sitting beside the road for $2,000. But the righteous went down on a knee. Mm-hmm. Good God from Zion.
Amen.
He'll show up, baby. Mm-hmm. He'll show up right on time. See, I want us to sing these songs, but I want us to have experience with it. Mm-hmm. And we say, show up right on time.
Yes, it will.
Mm-hmm. But what kind of experience you done had?
Amen.
God from Zion. Mm-hmm. My. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just give you praise, glory, and honor right now. We thank you for this word today. We thank you for saving us. We thank you for Jesus Christ. We thank you for making us the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. We thank you, God, for the gift of righteousness. Yeah.